We are sitting here in the thick of the chase. This is sort of, to put it in NFL terms, the AFC or NFC championship. Not bad for a 43-year-old.
Yeah, I think for me now, being in the sport as long as I've been in it, I just have a greater appreciation for winning races, as well as knowing that, you know, my career is not, you know, I don't have a lot of years ahead of me. This year has been extremely rewarding in so many ways, on and off the racetrack.
What a drive by Jeff Gordon.
One of the nicest parts as you progress through a career is that you become more comfortable with who you are.
Yeah, no, there's no doubt about it.
It seems like you're just talking more freely about yourself now. You like wine more than beer. You like to vacation in the south of France because it's beautiful there. It just feels like you're more comfortable saying, hey, this is what I like. This is who I am.
Yeah, and I think when I first came into the sport, you know, I wasn't from the South, and I wanted to fit in, and so I wanted to say all the right things and do all the right things, and you know, I had my sponsors, and I wanted to make sure they were happy. I wanted to make sure our fans were happy, make sure the team was happy. I was doing a lot of things, you know, for other people, and which worked out pretty good. But along the way, you start to realize, you know, who you are, who I am as a person, and that, you know, I like being comfortable with who I am, and because I've learned more about myself through my experiences, it allows me, yeah, to just say, you know what, it's about just being happy. That's what life's really all about. The only way you're really going to be happy is to be happy with who you are. And you know, I'm still learning those things, but I'm certainly a lot more comfortable today than I ever have been with it.
You don't feel like you have to listen to certain kind of country music or anything like that.
You know, I think that some of the backlash I got early on in my career was because I didn't fit that stereotype as a NASCAR driver, which was good and bad.
I don't know how much of the backlash against you was solely because of the mustache, though, because
that I agree with 100%. The haircut and the mustache deserve to.
That was troubling to look at some of those old photos. It really was.
You know what? You got to understand that you know, I was pure race car driver from the age of six. I was always trying to look older, and for some reason I thought that mustache would make me look older. But
let me put a caterpillar on my face. That could really help.
Yes. Thank goodness I finally got rid of that.
Dale Earnhardt Sr. was the guy when you really came into your own here at NASCAR, and the idea that he didn't welcome you. I mean, the Wonder Boy nickname was not a compliment. You cried when you won your first race, and he makes fun of you for being weak. I mean, that's what we read about high school bullies.
Sure. Yeah, I mean, Dale was that type of driver, and because he was the intimidator, he knew how to get into your head. The interesting thing is when he and I were having conversations away from cameras and media, I think he really appreciated what I was bringing to the sport, that I was not only challenging him, but challenging the fans. It was creating, you know, a good buzz and some rivalries, and he loved that. Now, it didn't stop him from you know, making fun of me and doing things at certain times.
Was it ever lonely? Did you feel kind of ostracized, or
as long as I was
difficult?
Winning races?
I mean, really, was that enough? People threw beer cans at you as you crossed the finish line.
Yeah, well, I look back on that, and I wish that happened every single weekend, because that was a great problem.
Crossing the finish line. And you did have remarkable confidence just continuing to forge your own path.
There became a point where we realized, okay, you know, I do bring something different. Let's take advantage of this. Let's do Milk Mustache ads. Let's go do, you know, Letterman. Let's, you know, go do other things that you know, you don't normally see NASCAR drivers doing.
It worked to such an incredible degree. Frito-Lay creates a potato chip shaped like you. You become the first NASCAR driver to ever host Saturday Night Live.
First, I was like, what in the heck am I doing here? How did this happen? But at the same time, I knew that was a huge moment, not only for me, but for NASCAR and for auto racing in the U.S.
Stick around, we'll be right back.
You helped bring Jimmy Johnson in, and in a way, though, that then leads to problems for you on the racetrack, because he's really good.
Yeah. You know, the thing with Jimmy is I met him, I saw him on the track, I thought he was doing amazing things. So you can't, you know, be disappointed to see somebody that's that good do that well. You know, did it put a thorn in my side at times, because, you know, maybe I could have won a championship if it weren't for him? Maybe. maybe. And our friendship was challenged at times because of that. But at the same time, I wouldn't have done it in any different. I just like him to share a little bit more.
I mean, he lives basically across the street from you, is
he
that
does,
right?
Yes. Yeah, I could throw a rock in his house.
Have you thought about it? Throwing rocks, many rocks in his house?
No, it's not like that. Well, I think we all realize if we do our jobs and do it well, then, you know, one of us should be in victory lane.
Familiar place and a sight for Jeff Gordon.
It has been 13 years since you have won the championship. As you went through that period in your late 30s where it had been a while since you had won, you were having increasing back problems. You started saying, yeah, I can't see myself driving a race car after I'm 40.
I wasn't having fun, number one. I don't know, I just didn't feel like I was contributing in the way that I had when we won championships. And so you start to question, you know, is it me? Is it, you know, the new rules of the car, the points? That, you know, you start to question these things. You're around fans all the time that are also questioning it. Then social media comes along and you get to see some of the stuff. And it's hard to climb yourself out of that hole.
Derek Jeter has talked about sort of the gift and the curse of winning a lot young, and that almost can start to affect how you compete and the pressure you put on yourself.
Absolutely. You know, I look at Derek in a lot of ways and how our careers have mirrored one another. You know, when you don't achieve the ultimate goal, which is winning the championship, or you go through a season where you don't even win a race, it's extremely disappointing. But I've always said, as long as I'm healthy, as long as I'm competitive and enjoying myself, I'm going to do it. And luckily, Alan Gustafson came along and he's just
new crew
great
chief.
Crew chief, and he has this great way of motivating me, kind of gave me a new life.
And you mentioned your family too, the energy that you get from wanting to race in front of your kids now being old enough to see what you do, and your daughter Ella is pretty excited about it, right?
Oh yeah, I mean the first time, you know, that she came to Victory Lane when she really could understand what that was all about, was a bit of a changing moment for me, because I realized, oh my gosh, you know, this means a lot to me to see my daughter understand what her dad does.
It's got to be very motivating.
It is, highly motivating.
And your stepdad got you into racing because he loved it. Now your daughter Ella is into racing and you put her in a quarter midget car because, hey, women are racing now.
She comes to the racetrack and she sees Danica. She says, oh my gosh, you know, there's a female driver out there. And you know, I knew at that point when I saw her interest that we had to at least put her behind the wheel.
If you do win this year, if that all does come together for you and you get to grab those kids and hold them up in Victory Lane, what is that moment going to be like compared to all those other championships where all you were holding up was a trophy?
Yeah, no comparison. The ultimate is winning the championship and having them to be a part of that. And I can't think of anything better in life than experiencing that moment, such an accomplishment with my whole family there and all of us taking it all in. It would be unbelievable. This is gonna be the best day ever.